Bulls.
They had already established themselves as an intelligent power pop band. Through the 80s and the 90s, they continued to release some really great records. But since 1982, Andy Partridge refuses to tour, pretty much because of his stage fright. They've just released a new album. It's called None Such. It's doing very well for the band, but no tours for them, only videos. And we have a lot of them for you in our spotlight on XTC, so don't go away.
I just think it's the circus-y stuff of, well, any circus-y stuff. Devo were just as bad as Led Zeppelin with lasers and dry eyes.
Tribe, a fragrance uprising.
Hello, Joe. What do you know?
No way of faking it. Just one with real attraction. Just for the taste.
Now is it wrong?
Diet Coke.
I used to make him wear things that he didn't like wearing. He used to wear them. I think he used to enjoy wearing women's clothes. I mean, we used to dress up in women's clothes at the time. We were called the Helium Kids at the time. This was a long time ago.
How did people take you when you dressed up in women's clothes?
They didn't. Used to walk away.
We drove people away en masse, didn't I?
No, we always had
Purges, mom.
Yeah, it wasn't an image they could accept? Something they couldn't relate to?
No, we just like... Well, I mean, my wear at the time was a gold fur trousers with a penis made out of studs around here and a tiger's tail and a pair of black stacking boots, which were really, you know, in 73, I was the kiddie. And
you could walk across bloody several streams with that.
I could, yeah. What else did I have? Oh, yes, I had a glittery Oxfam top that I had some padded wings put on. I had a pair of wing glasses, silver, that came out here. I had long hair at the time, used to wear Marilyn Monroe lips and makeup and a leather jacket with the door letters sewn over it. I was quite the lad, that on the left of the guitar. I just like carving the music up. I just have a... some people have got a pile it up mentality, I've got a take it away mentality.
He had a great sense of being able to see the song. I mean, when you've written a song, it's like your kid, you know. Might have too many arms, but it's still your kid and you love it. And he says, that's got too many arms. Chop that off, chop that off. You know, no, you can't lose that verse. You can't lose that chorus. You know, what about that bit? You can't, that's my favorite piece. But he did a lot of that and threw away, like, I don't know, a third or a half of any given song.
We enjoy the craft of songs much more now, mm-hmm. Whereas I think we just used to like making a row. Like that, and things like that. But now we enjoy songs more.
I think that comes across. Actually, when I listen to the songs, I almost can visualize. It's almost as if you're painting with words.
No, it's. I think we're all anti-video people, generally. So if you get your own pictures to our music, then great.